Dear students, welcome back. In the previous video, we had discussed about the meristematic tissue which is present in the plants. Now, in this video, we will discuss about the next type of plant tissue, that is permanent tissue. As I told you in the previous lecture, that plant tissue is divided into two basic categories. First is meristematic tissue and second is permanent tissue. As we all know, meristematic tissue is has ability to divide and they are responsible for growth and development of the plants. Apical meristematic tissue, lateral meristematic tissue and intercalary meristematic tissue is responsible for the different types of growth in the plants. Now, in this video, we will discuss about permanent tissue. What are permanent tissues? Permanent tissue is a tissue which lacks the ability of cell division. Aisa tissue jisme cell division ki ability absent hai. Which lacks the ability of cell division, such tissue is said to be permanent tissue. And permanent tissue is basically divided into two categories. First is simple permanent tissue and second is complex permanent tissue. So what is the basic difference between these two? Simple permanent tissue is a type of tissue which consists of simple types of cell. Simple type of cell, that is similar type. Suppose that this is a group of cell and this group of cell consists of same kinds of cell. So, aisa tissue jisme ek hi tarike ki sari cell ho, hai na? The group of similar cell, ek hi jaisi sari cell ho. Such permanent tissue is said to be simple permanent tissue. Therefore, we can say that simple permanent tissue is defined as the group of similar type of cell. No, that is simple permanent tissue. While in the case of complex permanent tissue, cells may be of different types. See here, this is also a group of cell, but the shape and the size of each cell is different. That means complex permanent tissue is a type of permanent tissue which is made up of different types of cell. No? And simple permanent tissue is further divided into three categories: parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma. Complex permanent tissue is divided into two categories, xylem and phloem. So, we will discuss each of these tissues in detail. What is the function of these tissues? Where these tissues are found in the plant body? So, we will start from parenchyma. What is parenchyma? Parenchyma is basically a simple permanent tissue which acts as a storage tissue in the plant. No? Basically, parenchyma stores food in the plant. But in some cases, parenchyma may store chlorophyll and parenchyma may store air. The parenchyma which stores chlorophyll is known as chlorenchyma. So what is chlorenchyma? Chlorenchyma is a type of parenchyma which stores chlorophyll. And what is parenchyma? Parenchyma is a type of parenchyma which stores air. May have seen the certain plants which are grown in the aquatic habitats. Such plants float on the water. How they float? They float because of the presence of air sacs in their body. No? And that air is present in the parenchyma of the plant body. So, parenchyma is the type of parenchyma which stores air. No? So, in the parenchyma, what are the points to be noted or what are the points to be learned in the parenchyma? Parenchyma is a type of simple permanent tissue. Parenchyma is a living tissue. The parenchyma acts as a storage tissue in the plant body. Parenchyma basically stores food, but in some cases, parenchyma also stores chlorophyll. That parenchyma is said to be chlorenchyma. And in some aquatic weeds or in some aquatic plants, parenchyma stores air. Such parenchyma is said to be parenchyma. What is collenchyma? These are two different things. This is chloren, C-H-L-O-R. That means the parenchyma which stores chlorophyll. Now this is collenchyma. What is collenchyma? Collenchyma is also a living simple permanent tissue and collenchyma is responsible for flexibility in the plant. Collenchyma provides flexibility. As we all know, the plants are flexible in nature. No, the stems of plants, the petiole of the leaves of the plants are very flexible. When winds are there, then plants are shows their flexibility to resist wind. If plants are not flexible, then in the small air currents also they will fall down. No, therefore to resist air, plants should be flexible. That property of flexibility in the plant is provided by collenchyma. So, what is the function of collenchyma in the plant? The function of collenchyma is to provide flexibility in the plant. Plants क्या होते हैं? Flexible होते हैं. हवाएं चलती तो plant झुक जाते हैं, है ना? और उनकी leaves roll करने लगती है to resist air current. Why it is necessary? It is necessary because for the proper survival of plant, plants should be live long. Therefore, plant have to resist the hard air currents also. Therefore, the collenchyma is a tissue of the plant which provides flexibility to the plants. And when we go through about the structure of collenchyma, then the cells of collenchyma is just like that. Suppose that this is the collenchyma tissue. It is a group of several similar types of cells. The cell which is present in collenchyma is thick at end. These all are living cells. As I told you, this is a living tissue. The corner of each cell, no, the corner of each cell in the collenchyma is slightly thick. Why they are thick? They are thick because of presence of lignin. Lignin is a substance which is present at the corner of the collenchymatous cell, which provide flexibility to the plant. Therefore, we have to understand why plants are flexible. So, plants are flexible, why? Because plant consists of collenchyma tissue. Afterwards, next is your sclerenchyma. What is sclerenchyma? Parenchyma and collenchyma is living. Why sclerenchyma is a dead tissue? No? The function of parenchyma is the storage. Either it can store food or chlorophyll or air. The function of collenchyma is, collenchyma provides flexibility to the plant. What is the function of sclerenchyma? As I told you, sclerenchyma is a dead tissue. That means sclerenchyma is made up of dead cells. Sclerenchyma helps in the anchorage and the support of the plant. Plant may stiffness, plant may hardness, कौन provide कर रहा है? तो plant की stiffness और plant में hardness कौन provide कर रहा है? Sclerenchyma provide कर रहा है. And sclerenchyma is responsible for stiffness and the hardness of the plant. It is usually found on the topmost cover of the coconut. Coconut में जो husk होती है ऊपर की, वो कितनी hard होती है? Why? Because in that husk of the coconut, sclerenchymatous tissue is there. So, in this video, we had discussed the little explanation of parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. No? Tomorrow, I will upload the notes of sclerenchyma, parenchyma and collenchyma in the description of this video. So, today, you may go through it and understood the concept, and tomorrow, you have to write the notes. That's all for this video. And in the next video, we will discuss about Jhelum and Phloem. Thank you.